Please
Jimmy
take
Connors
seat.
Will serve first.
Take a seat.
Best three out of five. Five sets. Connors against Lindell. Jay Schneider
Black.
Is the umpire.
Let's get it on. This should be a beauty. Power tennis at its best.
People still moving around, and Connors waits. Tell me tickets yesterday were being passed around outside the stadium for as much as $125. That's what we're waiting for to settle.
Oh, behind the court.
That's
please
up behind Jimmy
seat.
Connors.
Pat, you know, a lot of fans here were pulling against John McEnroe in their match yesterday, but so many people talked to me today when we got here saying, we're really sort of sorry that John lost. We wanted to see him in the finals, and there are a lot of people that are sorry that he's not in the finals. This should be a great one, though.
Love 15.
I don't care how many times you've been here or how many tournaments you've won, you have to be a little tight right now.
Strange thing about the record of these two players, the nine times that they've played, the first nine times, Jimmy Connors won in straight sets, never lost a set. And the last time they played, Lindell won 6-1, 6-1 in straight sets.
Out. 30, 15.
Not too much should be taken to the fact, though, that Connors won the first eight matches, because at that time Lindell was just coming onto the circuit, and he has only been around about 3 or 4 years.
30-15.
Definitely some nerves, Tony, on Lindell's part. His
40,
feet
50.
Aren't moving very well at this stage. And
he didn't make a very good swing at that one. He just sort of blocked the backhand, just trying to float her back deep.
And those of you who've been watching the Packers and the Rams, welcome to U.S. Open Tennis. This is the 40, first 30. Game of the first set. It is 40-30 with Connors serving.
You know, Pat, you talk about nerves, opening games. Chris Everett Lloyd admitted that she was very tentative in the first set yesterday of her final and her victory for her sixth title. And you know she's been around quite a bit.
Yes.
That was the shot that Linda was really able to penetrate in their last meeting, taking the pace off the ball with an underslice backhand to Connors' forehand.
Connors.
Connors really stayed down well on that volley. It wasn't that easy a volley. Not as easy as it looked, that's for sure.
Few shots are as easy as these people make it look.
They do hit the ball pretty hard, don't they?
Interesting play from Lindell, too, Tony. Did you pick that? He played that little short slice ball, making Connors come to the net. That was a deliberate attempt to bring Connors in on the attack.
It was short and low, and Jimmy had to let go of one hand. He couldn't hit the two-hander like he normally would. Great point for Lindell.
Very, very hot and humid. Temperature was over 100 on the court yesterday, and I think it's hotter today.
Advantage, base.
Another look at Connors taking advantage of the short ball. He gets it high, driving it down into Lendl's court, deep with pace, closing in the net. Lendl's attempt at the backhand cross court failed. So we come back live at deuce. I think we're going to see a lot of that. If Connors gets the short ball, he's going to be coming in, particularly if it's high enough, he'll really crank it. If it's low, he'll try to just place it deep and get into a good volleying position. Break point for Lendl.
And that's the type of game Lendl would like to develop, longer baseline rallies. He hits the ball with topspin from the back of the court and less chance of him making the first error. Connors wants to hit five or six shots and set himself up for the short ball so that he can attack, finish the rally.
Game of the first set of the men's finals. Yvonne Lendl has a service break. This is a first set action, Mr. William Paley, the chairman of the board of CBS. Remarkable man. Not a very satisfying or impressive way to begin things. Double fault.
Tony, do you expect Connors to step in on Lendl's second serve, try to really thump the return?
I think it depends on what Lendl tries to do. I don't think Yvonne will be coming in much behind the second serve. That serve almost hit the baseline. It was so long. I think Jimmy will try to do what he can off the second serve. Turn to serve we were speaking of, as Connors gets to triple break point. If he returns Lendl's first serve that effectively, it's going to be tough for Lendl.
Those of you who watch the Eagles and the Redskins, welcome to the U.S. Open of 1982. This is first set action. Yvonne Lendl won the first game, breaking Jimmy Connors. And also, those of you, as Lendl fires a service ace, those of you who watch the Bears and the Lions, 30, welcome 40. To the U.S. Open. Break point still.
We have a speed gun that'll clock some of these serves. The approximate time of that last serve is 108 miles an hour. That is a jug speed gun. Yes.
Lendl gets even very quickly. Deuce.
Marvelous to have that kind of a weapon.
Oh.
Wide. Great point for Connors.
Another of what seems to be limitless sellout crowds. There you see the magnificent tennis center stadium. All over the top, it's full, it's deuce.
And you got quite a few sitting in the aisles on the steps as well.
Wherever they could sit.
Fifth break point in this game for Connors. Very weak swing at that forehand, Nuke.
It was, and that's that short ball that you and I have talked about, Tony, that doesn't bounce very high and makes Lendl move forward, play off the front foot, out near pace. Doesn't seem to like it off the forehand or backhand, but not too many players give it to him.
Did something that McEnroe was unable to do all day yesterday. Break Lendl's serve.
I have to feel that was a very important game for Jimmy Connors, because coming off their last match, and I know this is an entirely different situation, the final of the US Open, but Connors led 40-15 in the first game and dropped it. Led 40-11 in that game and nearly dropped it.
Of all of us.
Lendl standing way over to hit a forehand. He's saying to Jim, you're going to have to ace me up the middle of the second serve. I'm going to. Jimmy got into his body.
They wailed it out. Connors takes a 2-1 lead in the first set. This is a man who enjoys his tennis, Mr. Henry Kissinger, his wife Nancy on the left. He's here every year. It is 2-1 Connors with Lendl serving.
Thank you.
break point.
It sure was. They threw everything they had at one another, but there was a really bad line call in that rally right there. Lendl didn't even play that ball. Great topspin lob at the end. Tony, that looked like it was about 3 inches out.
It did look like it was out, but it happened very quickly as Lendl was sort of half volleying it right as it came off the court. He still won the point, 15 love.
Good lesson there, Trey. Keep playing.
You bet. You keep playing and then worry about the call afterwards.
The big thing about that first long rally we saw was that they threw every type of shot at one another. Slow one, slice, topspin, short, long. It was a real sort of probing rally.
Power tennis at its best.
McEnroe seemed to be a little afraid to do yesterday, and that's drive the backhand across court to Lendl's forehand side. Lendl is so powerful off the forehand that a lot of players are scared to play it.
40-50.
Pretty big serve there. 108 miles an hour approximately. Never won a Grand Slam singles title. He was in the finals of the French last year and lost to Borg.
I tell you what, though, at 22 years of age, you want to bet he's never going to win one?
No. I don't like that bet.
Not at all. 2-2. Connors didn't like the call, but...
Long.
Lines were correct that it was out. Replay the point.
Lendl is going up for a word now with the chair umpire, Jay Snyder.
I really thought that ball was out. I thought it was a good call, the first one he made.
Even close to the line umpire. Yeah, but you can overrule and you know that it wasn't even close.
Close for me to change, right?
Yvonne said you can overrule.
It wasn't even close.
It wasn't even close, that's right.
It was just like the one before. That
looked about the same,
about 2 or 3 inches out.
They'll replay the point. That's the weather conditions. 85 degrees hotter on the court, of course. Humidity 39%. And winds of 7 miles an hour, inconsequential, really.
So humidity down from yesterday, which could help Connors, but it is boiling hot on the court. I sat out in one of the boxes during the mixed doubles for a while, and boy, it's really hot.
One other thing that might benefit a little bit is that there's a cloud cover now that there was not around earlier. This is the first point since we're replaying in game five.
I wonder how that base linesman feels that made that call a while ago. It's only 2-2 in the first set, and he's got to be a little unsure whether he's made 2 mistakes or not.
They do a terrific job overall, and I think they deserve a lot of credit. The lines people here are awfully good.
Love.
game to Connors, and he leads 3-2 in the first set. Pat Summerall with John Newcomb and Tony Trabert. Men's singles final. Jimmy Connors leads Yvonne Lendl 5-2 first set. Connors says he likes to play in New York. I'm sure he likes to play everywhere. He wouldn't play as well as he does, but
quiet,
he says
please.
These fans are nuts, and so am I.
Yeah,
so we get along fine.
He gets them going, too.
The court.
Lendl serving with new balls. That 5-2 lead is just one service break, so when you're behind, you say hold serve and try to get the break and hold, and I'm even. Oh!
Love.
Connor's ball was wide.
It wasn't a bad return, though, was it?
Look at that first serve percentage, 80% against 38% for Lendl. And I never forget what the great Don Budge told me years ago. He said when he went out to start serving his first service game, he never did serve the first server too hard all his might, because if it didn't go in, there is Don and his wife, Lori. If it didn't go in, he said it might take me a set or so to get the groove on my serve. He liked to spin a couple balls in, get the feel, relax, and then increase the tempo and the pace. Saw Jimmy whiff that one. He probably not won't want to sign him up, huh?
He was here looking at Vilas.
Few rallies like that, and if Connors was having trouble yesterday with cramps, it's going to take it out of him if it goes into a long match.
All
he was
right.
Really stretching then.
Changing direction.
Yeah, that would have really taken it out of his legs and his back. Changed direction about four times during the one rally.
That serve was approximately 110 miles an hour on our speed gun.
Whoa.
40-15.
Not a bad return.
No.
Came back twice as hard as the serve. Did we time the return?
Yeah.
By Lendl. 5-3 in the first
Connors
set.
Connors leads 5-3.
You know, as a little psychological battle. Sorry, that attendance.
Total attendance is phenomenal, isn't it?
Yeah.
Keep getting bigger and bigger. I think it was 90,000 the first open in 1968 over at Forest Hills.
I think that's correct.
Little psychological battle going on down there at the moment, which I'll mention after this point.
Connors will serve.
Nice lob, plenty of air.
Good defensive lob.
It's been two or three times during this first set when Lendl has missed key shots on the forehand. Jimmy has given him a long look as if to say, well, ha-ha, and now I know I got your weakness. And that last game when Lendl hit a forehand winner down the line, he gave Connors about a five-second look as if to say, no more.
Thank you.
more time now, a little more deliberate. This is the stretch two-handed 15, volley. 30. Both feet off the ground, able to cut it back cross-court. Patty Connor is Jimmy's wife, anxiously watching. Jimmy's serving at 15-30, but he leads 5-3 in this first set. Good chance here for Lendl to get back in it. Lendl didn't miss those kind of shots when he played McEnroe.
I think Jimmy's putting just a little more on his approach shots. They're coming through a bit faster, and he's getting into good net position. Ball skidding through.
Staying a little lower.
But still the same thing. Connor's not frightened at all to attack Lendl on the forehand side.
Some shot, that ball jumped up sort of away from him a little bit.
He had both feet off the ground. 40-30. Connors leads first set 5-3. Connors in the second set. He won the first 6-3. And Jimmy will serve. It's out.
Regardless of whether Jimmy Connors wins or loses this match, he will be number one on the ATP computer. Lendl will be two, and John McEnroe has slipped to three, and Vilas will be four.
Top four seeds in this tournament.
Ready, love.
That, by the way, the man making those calls is a different linesman than the individual who began. You might recall Lendl made a couple of visits to the umpire, and they made a change.
Interesting shot, Tony.
The miss?
The miss, yeah.
He sort of straightened up as he hit that ball. He was bent down nicely, and just as he hit it, he sort of straightened his legs. Ended up hitting the net. If you bend down to hit that ball, I think you got to stay down there throughout the stroke.
It's a shot that Jimmy hasn't made many mistakes on during this match so far, but it's one that has plagued him in the past on certain occasions.
Him close in now when he gets the opportunity to start to the net. Here he comes. Now watch him as that ball's chipped high and short. He keeps closing in, going forward. Got that ball as high as he could over the top of the net and really crunched a forehand volley. So Lendl will be serving at 1-3. In trouble.
Connors won the first set, 6-3.
All he knows how to do. Got to admire the guy. He gives you 110% all the time out there.
I think the last six or seven games, though, he's been putting about 150% into it. And if Lendl can fight his way back into this second set, could tell on Jimmy if the match goes to four or five sets.
Of course, it's going to get a little cooler. It is now about quarter after five.
Four aces by Lendl.
30-15.
Lendl seems to have slowed his game down, Tony, as far as walking around, taking more time. A better stroke at the ball.
Something he didn't do yesterday at all.
That's what I was going to say exactly, Pat. We don't see him miss hit those kind of forehands when he's not being pressed at all.
You think that's caused by bad footwork through nerves?
I think it's nerves for sure. Can't be looking at the ball very well. He's got to really be worried.
Showed you total paid attendance a minute ago. This is people who passed through the gates here at the tennis center, 407,450. That is the largest attendance for any one tournament in the history of this game.
And we salute the USTA and Bill Talbert, the tournament director, and his staff. Marvelous job. You know, I just watching here, you feel that Jimmy is able to rush Lindell, not give him time to make those big, long swings at the ball. Also exposing him sometime to some slower footwork.
Especially when he moves across to the forehand side, Lindell seems to run a little quicker when running to his backhand than he does to his forehand. Maybe that's because he's leaning towards the backhand, because everybody usually plays it.
Tony, so many times that Connors likes to take the ball on the rise. Maybe that rushes Lindell a little bit more, too.
It does indeed. It gives you less time to recover and get set. And, of course, when Jimmy takes on the rise, he normally hits it with a lot of pace. And if he's got good depth on it, it's going to handcuff you a little bit. And if a player is used to taking a big looping swing at it, of course, it gives you less time.
Something's happening out there right now, because the last two games, there has to be about seven or eight unforced errors.
First serve was a fault.
Tough game, but Lindell wins it, holds a serve. And it's 3-2 Lindell. 3-2 Connor, sorry. Pat Summerall with John Newcomb and Tony Travert. Jimmy Connors won the first set of his men's singles final, 6-3. He leads 3-2 and is serving in the second set.
Few times that Connors come to the net and not been successful.
Lindell adopted a different tactic off the forehand that time. Instead of going for a clean winner, just put a soft looping shot over, forcing Connors to volley up.
He is slowing things down considerably.
Lindell's gotten something in his eye. You know, he carries sawdust in his pocket. I think sometimes it might get a little bit in your eye.
Getting set up on a lot of short balls, isn't he, by attacking the forehand?
Yep.
Is Lindell trying to over top spin it back, do you think, and that's causing the balls to go short? I mean, if he flattened out a bit more, he may get a little bit more depth on the ball.
I don't think he's confident enough right now to drive through that ball like he was yesterday. And again, it can be part of the way Jimmy Connors is playing. You don't normally see Lindell miss hit many forehands. Bad tactic on Lindell's part to try to take advantage of Connor's second serve. If he can get on that forehand and drive it. The wily veteran, Jimmy Connors, at age 30. Doing some job right now.
40, 50.
Arthur Ashe, our Davis Cup captain, who replaced Captain Trabert.
Connors serving at 40-15, second set. He leads three games to two.
Game, Connors.
Ball stayed very low. There is Gene Jankowski, who is CBS Broadcast Group president. And a tennis fan, Lindell just ripped off his fifth ace.
Approximately 106 miles an hour.
And there's our CBS president of sports, Neil Pilson, along with his wife.
15 all.
Jim Rosenfield, also in attendance. We got all of our leaders here, CBS Broadcast Group. Executive Vice President Walter Cronkite, of course, is behind him. There's Walter. A real CBS sport.
Pat, if Connors should win today, it'll only be the seventh time in the last 20 years that one man has been able to win both the U.S. and Wimbledon titles in the same year. He did it in 74, McEnroe did it in 81, Laver in 69 and 62, and John Newcomb did it in 67,
30 all.
Roy Emerson in 64.
30 all. Connors leads 4-2, second set. He won the first one 6-3.
Second time that Lendl is serving volleyed, I believe, Nuke.
40-30.
Is it something you think he should do more of?
Well, he better try to do something different, because whatever he's doing now isn't working. At least mix it up a little bit. Come back live, 40-30.
Get the feeling that Lendl is boxing himself in at the moment. A little bit unsure about what sort of game plan he should have. A lot of that, of course, is caused by Connors' great play. Lendl's first serve has let him down badly in this match thus far. Uh-huh. 44% of his first serves, and that is not good.
That one was right in the strike zone.
Take another look and watch what happens when you put it in the strike zone. Up high and right down the middle of the court, and Connors popped off that crisp forehand volley. Back live at deuce.
Wow, that only just made the net, didn't it? Mm-hmm. Crept over. A lot of his second serves have landed very short.
Thank you.
Break point for Connors.
He hit four straight balls to Lindell's forehand.
And just not a good shot from Lindell here. Watch where the ball lands. Forehand, that one landed on the service line. Another one landing on the service line, giving Jimmy plenty of time to attack,
five,
put
please.
The ball where he wants to. Just seems to have lost all confidence in his forehand at this time.
And that's supposed to be the strength. That's good serve. Good time.
That's a game plan that I read in Big Bill Tilden's tennis book many, many years ago. One way that you can attack someone if you feel confident enough, or you got enough confidence in yourself, is go to their strength, break their strength down. And if you can do that, you got them.
Well, Vince Lombardi said.
Yeah, that was his theory.
He must have learned it from Bill Tilden.
Advantage Connors.
Again, great point for Jimmy Connors.
He said if you destroy the leader's confidence, the followers will quit. Second set. Connors serving. He won the first game. He leads 5-2. He won the first point, I'm sorry. He leads 5-2 in the second set. He won the first 6-3.
Tony, is that the first backhand passing shot Lindell's made in the match?
To the best of my knowledge, it is. It's the only one I can remember. Connors' last serve was timed at about 102 miles per hour. Lindell's been up around 111.
I think it's the first time I've ever seen him do it.
He tried to do it off a forehand on the second serve, but missed the forehand. He's got to try to vary the game. He's not being successful. Has not been successful thus far. Break point for Ivan Lendl.
I think Connors must have been watching the match yesterday with McEnroe and Lindell, because about four times so far Lindell has tried that little cross-court dink shot. He was successful with it against McEnroe, but Jimmy's been sitting on it.
Ah!
Set point for Connors.
Wins the second set, 6-2. He won the first, 6-3.
Connors leads 2 sets to love. Third set, Lendl to serve. Quiet, please.
I just got a dirty look from Jimmy.
You did? Why?
Yep. I don't know whether you saw it, Trey.
Quietly.
I think he heard on the TV yesterday that I said I thought Lendl was going to win.
Well, people, you know, see me and say, I don't think he's going to win, or I think Jimmy's going to whatever. And I say, we don't know more about it than you do. Just, you know, it's just a guess. If we knew that not much about it, we'd be in Vegas, put a lot of money on it.
Well, one lady walked up to me before the match and she started going mad at me because I said I thought Lendl was going to win. I said, hey, that's not a personal like or dislike. Talking about tennis.
I had a guy take a swing at me one time because I gave an incorrect temperature. Wilson, Neil, if you, our president, if you duck just a little bit, we could see Tom Wyman if you're listening. Thank you.
Two handsome gentlemen.
Tom Wyman is the CBS president. Thank you.
No, Nuke, I think the key for Lendl, if he's going to get into this match, is he's going to have to serve better. He's served pretty well in this game, but his very low percentage of first serves in the first two sets. ...47%.
Again, we talked about power tennis.
Lendl had better give away that little cross-court dink shot now. I mean, he hasn't... I don't think he's won one of them, and Connors is coming so close to the net that he's got to start coming up with some lobs.
He made one good backhand offensive lob early.
That was in the first game.
Right.
Mm-hmm.
I think he's only done one lob since then, a nice defensive one, which caused Connors to miss the smash.
Quietly stand back behind that baseline. Now, Connors has him on the run. In this attempt at the passing shot, just catches the tape. Jimmy was right there anyway. Probably could have volleyed into the open court. The back live break point for Jimmy Connors. First game of the third set. Connors has won the first two, 6-3, 6-2.
More like Linda.
Yes. That was a pretty easy shot then. It wasn't a good approach shot, but it was a good tactic on such an important point. Tremendous amount of pressure on Linda Lynn.
Rush him if you can. Instant pressure.
We've almost been an early match point.
Attorney General of the United States, William French Smith, among the 20,000 or so enjoying this tennis and watching Jimmy Connors on a roll at the moment. He won the first set 6-3, took the second 6-2, and is serving at 2-1 in the third.
Here's one of the reasons, Pat. 25 unforced errors for Connors thus far, 49, almost double the amount for Yvonne Lendl.
First serve.
I think Lendl's lost a little spirit, Tony, or is he being beaten into submission at the moment?
I think a combination of both. Give Jimmy Connors a lot of credit because he is making Lendl play below Lendl's normal form. And it's because Jimmy's played so well. He's hit the ball consistently. He's hit it with pace and with depth. He's used the whole court, moving around. And Nuke, I think what you point out earlier is very true. Jimmy played his forehand, which I think surprised him and has broken him down.
40 left.
And that was awful close to just sort of stand and look at. Not even go over and attempt to play.
I guess when you're on a roll, you just keep going. Everything you do turns to gold.
Sometimes when you mishit that ball, as Lendl did that one, it can do some strange things.
Extra spin. That ball jumped up a little higher than normal.
Connors leads 3-2, third set. He won the first one 6-3, the second 6-2. This is the men's singles final. Yvonne Lendl against Jimmy Connors. Pat 90. Summerall with Tony Trabert and John Newcomb.
First serve percentage, excuse me, Patrick, 68%, and Lendl's still below 50%, 46. That is not good. That's been one of his problems. His biggest problem has been Jimmy Connors. Another look. The short volley here by Lendl pays off. Connors just barely gets to it.
Forced to play a single-handed backhand. That's not fair.
There were some reports yesterday you might have heard us say that Jimmy had back cramps, leg cramps. Get some information that he felt that he took an iron tablet too soon after he played. Cramp up a little bit. But I talked to him last night, and he said everything was fine. He was ready to go.
And I talked to Dr. Gary Wadler, who administered to him, Jimmy, and told him, get some fluids in now. Don't wait for the match.
This is where Jimmy has to really tighten up his concentration. Plane flew over the first one of the day. I guess the wind must have changed just as he was playing that shot, and I think it upset his concentration, forced that error.
The last 3 days have been very quiet as far as the planes are concerned until that one.
15-30.
That's his second ace, 15-30. Both of them been almost in the same spot, right down the middle line.
All. Obviously, Lendl very unhappy with the call.
Someone yelled out to Lendl, why don't you go home? And that was the reason for the boos. And then some lady just followed that with, stay here, Ivan, also known as Ivan. And that's the reason for the applause.
The crowd were booing the fan that yelled out.
That's right.
Not Lendl.
That's right. Double faults. Wojtek Fibak, that's Lendl's advisor.
Yeah, Lendl keeps looking at him over in the stand and has increasingly done so in the last set and a half.
Break point for Lendl.
Tennis goes past 7 o'clock. That could change. And if Lendl keeps serving like that, the match could change. That's his seventh ace.
At approximately 107 miles per hour.
Oh! Lights are on now in the stadium, the National Tennis Center. Louis Armstrong Stadium. Double fault and a bad one. They're all bad, but that one was not even close. That's his third.
He mishit that one. You do that once in a while when you're trying to get spin on it. You catch an edge of the racket, and off she goes.
Yeah. There's some planes leaving LaGuardia, and that one went in a different direction.
15:30. A winner.
30-all.
Lendl's broken Connors twice. Connors has broken Lendl 5 times thus far in this match.
Apart from the first set, Tony, I don't think the standard has been a really high.
Jimmy's played well, but I'm disappointed in the quality of the tennis, particularly by Lendl. Oh! Again, you can give a lot of that credit to Jimmy Connors, but Lendl has not played well, even though Jimmy is hitting the ball extremely well.
Like that. Can't help but feel that Lendl should be going more down the line on this shot. But once again, Jimmy setting it up, playing wide to Lendl's forehand, getting the ball short on his own backhand, and then he can either go down the line or come sharply back across court for the winner, as he did then.
We come back at deuce. Ace, number 8.
Advantage, Lendl.
Because if you look at the Masters final in January, Vitas Gerulaitis had Lendl down 2 sets to 0 in a service break. Lendl came back and won it in 5 sets.
Paul! Allen missed. Match exactly 2 hours old now.
Lendl
leads 4-3 in the 3rd set. Connors serving 3-4, 3rd set. Won the first 2 sets. Lights are on in the stadium now. Difficult to see at the moment, but in just a few minutes the lights will take over. Packed house.
Sort of the way it's been going for Ivan Lendl, that was a very simple shot. Just trying to block it down the line deep and get into the volleying position and hit it well over the baseline.
Ah! 30-15.
Guy's relentless, isn't he? Keep the pressure on you. Jimmy's very good at controlling the pace of a match, whether he's serving or receiving. When he's receiving, he can look down and fiddle the strings in his racket and make the server wait if he wants to.
Pigeon comes in. I mean, a real one.
For a minute, I thought he was going to come get us.
Can't find a seat.
Doesn't have a ticket.
Only the second double fault by Connors. Patty Connors in the middle.
Patty Connors is looking a little pensive about is the fact that Connors has gone off the ball just a little bit. Also, Lendl is coming up with a couple of better shots than he has previously in the match. Instead of trying to dink that one across court, he drove it across there.
It's deuce.
Also, Jimmy's approach shot wasn't as deep as they have been earlier in the match. Gave Lendl more time to play the shot. Crucial games right now.
Connors has been to that 41 times and won 25. Pretty good percentage.
I think what happened in the middle of this set, Connors leading 2 sets to 11, 3-1. Looked like the match was virtually over. He played a bad game, let Lendl back into the set.
Chris volley by Jimmy Connors gets him even at 4-all.
Back at Louis Armstrong Stadium, men's singles final, Connors and Lendl. Connors will serve. That's a correct score.
Right, please.
Cincinnati 27, Houston 6. Well, I had it incorrectly a minute ago.
Makes me feel better being
a Cincinnati kid.
A native of Cincinnati.
Connors serving 4-5. In the third.
Quite a shot.
Wow, where did that one come from? He had to be about 10 feet behind the baseline when he struck that. Great shot to start the game off with.
Again, he slows down the tempo.
Keeps lifting his legs like he's just a little bit leg weary.
Done a lot of running.
Talking about Connors now.
Yeah.
Miss it on the return by Lendl.
Pretty low.
Nuke, I know you won this championship twice. Tony won it twice. You know who the only man is to ever win it twice without losing a set?
Is he ugly?
Yeah. Is he sitting next to me?
Does he lead the same early nightlife that you do?
Yes. Tony Trabert.
Weak fields back in those days.
Ready for tea.
You know, it's been all Jimmy Connors in this match, as you see Patty looking on Patty Connors. But it, I have a feeling, excuse me, that if Lendl somehow wins this set, things can be very, very different.
You're saying that 8 years in age difference might have its effect.
It might have its effect, and it could also have an effect psychologically on Lendl getting into the match when he's really been steamrolled up to this point. Jimmy sort of let him back in this third set. He led it 3-1 and played a poor game for him. Pretty face. Looks better when she's smiling.
The one on the left.
Yes, of course. Tension is mounting.
Pumped up at the end of the second set, and he's been strangely quiet the last five games.
He came up with a good serve and a big shot.
Deuce.
Temperature has dropped considerably, down to 80 degrees, 5 degrees. Humidity remains about the same. A little bit of a breeze, not much. The cooler it gets, if we're correct, the more it would benefit Connors.
Connors trying to hold serve and get even at 5-all in the third set.
See Connors coming in from a deep position in the court, but he did make a pretty good
Deuce.
Approach. He's just on the baseline and on the way in. And Lendl had enough time to get set up properly and made a terrific backhand down the line. We come back at Deuce. You don't seldom see someone try to make an approach shot, making contact with the ball as you're standing near the baseline. It's just too great a distance for the ball to trail and for you to get into a good volleying position. Second time, it is set point Lendl.
Game and third set, Lendl 6-4.
Connors leads. Start off with Lendl serving the first game of set number four.
Please remain in your seats, ladies and gentlemen.
And singles final.
Fourth set, Lendl to serve.
Pat, I watched Jimmy real close during that last game, just concentrating on his legs all the time, and I really think that he's starting to tighten up in his thigh muscles. It's causing some of those errors that he's making, either his thigh muscles or his lower back.
Psychologically, you would think Lendl would be sky high right now.
He doesn't look it though, does he?
No, he doesn't.
Terrific approach shot. Made the volley easy.
Love 30.
Came in well on this shot, and Lendl, though, on the passing shot, he is being forced, but the passing shot went nowhere. It went straight back down the middle of the court.
Jimmy's ball landed about 2 feet from the baseline with pace.
What a great return. And it's triple break point for Connors.
I think that return took him totally by surprise. He didn't expect that back.
He's used to just walking in after those big serves and getting a weak return, dominating the play from there.
Oh!
Number 10 by Lendl.
30-40.
Approximately 111 miles per hour. 78 feet baseline to baseline, so it gets to you in a hurry. To you and by you.
Super rally, and this time Lendl was looking for the great shot from Connors. It almost caught him, as you see him come on this great drive down the line. Jimmy really made him play a tough volley here. That's one that you could spoon up, but he played it firm. I don't know how Jimmy reached that ball, let alone get it back in such a good position.
How about the great volley by Lendl?
It was great anticipation to follow through on his volley.
And it's deuce.
The first lob that Lendl has put up for some time, and it almost caught Connors by surprise.
Again, break point.
Look at this. Connors has been to the net 48 times, won 28 points. Lendl only 10 times, won 5 points.
Get an idea who's doing the tacking.
Oh.
first game of the fourth set. Don Shula leading the Dolphins, and as he's done so long, he leads them very well, doesn't he?
It's terrific.
Connor's leading here, you see. He won the first two sets, 6-3 and 6-2. Lindell won the third, 6-4. Connors will serve, leading One Love in the fourth. He is up a service break.
Got the let court judge with that one. Lendl's percentage of serves coming up some to 51%. Jimmy's at 69%. As Lendl goes after the first serve, he's trying to hit aces and hit it harder than Connors, but Jimmy does change the pace some. He spins a lot more the first serves.
He should be trying to achieve about 70% of first serves into play then.
Again, a miss hit off a fairly easy ball. Lendl has committed 40 unforced errors thus far off the forehand. Time by Ivan Lendl.
40-15.
Connors leads 40-15, serving at One Love with the service break. Getting close to 7 o'clock, Patrick.
I thought at one time we'd be doing a lot of filling. Enjoying it. And of course 60 minutes comes up as soon as the tennis is over. It looks now like we won't make it off at our prescribed time of 7 o'clock Eastern time. So we'll just slide that whole schedule. Except on the West Coast, you'll see the CBS Sunday night schedule at its normal time.
Jimmy doesn't believe it. Martina Navratilova. That was the 11th ace for Lendl.
That's long.
Smart tactic by Connors. I think if he does that a few times, that'll work against Lendl, plus it'll put more pressure on Lendl's second serve.
Oh.
Lendl.
Game to Lendl. And it's 2-1 Connors in the fourth set. Connors leads 3-2 and he serves.
And he has a service break. In the court change, Jimmy drank a lot of water, also poured a cup of water over his head to cool himself down a little bit.
At the net, you see. Excuse me, Trey. 58, 35 points, one for Connors. Lindell's been there 12 times, won 5 points.
It's not many times the net on a hard surface when you're midway through the fourth set. Particularly when you serve and have ground strokes like Lendl does.
15 all.
You know, it's amazing the set scores 6-3, 6-2, 6-4, and 3-2, and that's taken 3 hours to play that much when they're hitting the ball this hard. Could take that long if you had two people just pushing the ball back out there. And they're really going after it.
Kind of return by Lendl. This is when you want to really turn the screw and really get it going.
Miami. Over the Jets over at Chase Stadium with about 3 minutes to go.
See, Lendl's doing all the running. Jimmy gets in on a short ball here and drives it, let's see, just inside the sideline.
Yeah, that was a great shot from Connors then because Lendl's ball had a lot of topspin on it, was moving around.
40-15.
Good anticipation at the net by Jimmy Connors.
He leads 4-2. in the fourth set. NFL schedule next week, doubleheader games. Dallas at St. Louis, New Orleans, Chicago, Philadelphia at Cleveland. Then Detroit at Los Angeles, San Francisco at Denver, where I'll be, Washington at Tampa Bay.
You're doing the Denver-San Francisco game.
Mile High Stadium. Great place to broadcast a game.
Chase that last shot. He's up a service break, and that ball was so far away, he was going to do a good job just to get his racket on it. He might start thinking about conserving a little energy here. All he has to do is hold his serve two more times, and he's the champion. Just had words because the smash by Lendl came very close to Jimmy Connors.
And of course, Lendl has that reputation. He's knocked some folks down.
Well, Jimmy's wagging a finger at Lendl, but Lendl refuses to look at him.
You catch that one?
That might be just enough adrenaline pump for Jimmy just carrying right on through.
I'll never forget seeing Lendl hit Gerolaitis in the head last January at Madison Square Garden.
Because that was with a short forehand. Not a bad play to go at the person at the net like that when it's a short ball, but this was a different situation. He didn't really come that close to him, but as much closer it might have been.
40-30.
We got some great talent sitting in that corner behind where Jimmy's returning serve now. The all-time greats, Fred Perry, Don Buds, Frankie Parker, Althea Gibson.
Buddy Satius.
Dean Victor.
And Lendl.
Came to Lendl. Connors leads 4-3 in the fourth.
Connors leads 4-3, fourth set. New balls.
Connors serving with new balls.
Should have put up a high defensive lob. It was virtual no chance to make the passing shot.
And also, I think Lendl makes the mistake, as you mentioned earlier, going back cross court with his forehand into the two-handed side of Jimmy Connors. I think it's a better shot than his one-hander. Times at the net and points won. Connors been in there 62 times and won 38. Lendl's gone in 15 times and won 8 of them.
to remind our stations along the line that on the next court change, we'll give you a station break. 15 left.
Covered that forehand nicely coming in, meaning that he rolled the ball just enough to bring it down real deep in the court.
Match exactly 3 hours old now. Connors won the first set 6-3, the second 6-2, Lindell 6-4 in the third, and it's 4-3 Connors in the fourth, and he's serving at 30 love.
This is Jimmy Connors.
Quiet, please.
Trying to stay calm.
Impossible.
Connors at his best, running for this shot. Look like you can see him standing up like that. Jimmy loves to play to this crowd. He knows that pumps him up when he gets really excited and carried away. It's also got to be a bit of a downer on his opponent.
15 all.
That's the best way to answer the crowd getting pumped up is to come up with an ace.
13 aces. Connors didn't like the call. That's history.
Through the line, didn't it? Almost took the line with it.
Lendl did that an awful lot of times against John McEnroe. He has not been that successful in this match today with that shot.
You've got to hand it to Lendl in this game after that first point, trailing 2-1, one go came away from losing the match. Would have been an awful temptation to just sort of say, well, boy, there's too much against me. Let's come back with two aces and a winner.
That was his 14th ace.
And that was 105 miles an hour approximately on that last serve. When we come back, Connors will be serving for the match at 5-4.
And we'll be back with more tennis action after this word from your local station. Pat Summerall with Tony Trabert and John Newcomb and Jimmy Connors and Yvonne Lindell, men's singles final. Connors leads 5-4 in the fourth set. He leads 2-1, and he'll be serving. Lindell out quickly and out first.
In the entire match, Connors has made 23 unforced errors on the forehand, 24 in the backhand for a total of 47. Lendl's made 67 unforced errors. And here we go. Showtime.
President-elect of the USTA, Hunter Delatour.
About 6 to 8 feet behind the baseline. Return the serve.
Two more points.
This game, this one game.
If Lendl's going to stand back that far behind the baseline, I think it's Jimmy Smart to come in, but I'm surprised that Lendl wouldn't be topping the return to try to get it low. If he block it with a little underspin, it stays up.
30-15.
I think he was surprised that Connors came in twice already out of 3 points.
He better stay alert because I think he might try to do it again.
Connors wins this one. They love him in New York.
Quiet, please.
Went for it.
Jimmy Connors has won the U.S. Open. The singles champion. coming off his victory at Wimbledon, there might be some adjustment in the rankings.
He is definitely number one on the ATP computer. Lendl is two.
Watch the incoming USTA president, Hunter Dellator, and his reaction. He was watching. Some fluid. We'll have a word with Jimmy Connors. John Tesh is down courtside. We'll be back.